You know, our band started touring in vans, playing these tiny little like Knights of Columbus halls and stuff like that. So I've literally slept everywhere. The most difficult thing about being on the road to me is living out of a suitcase. So the one item I can't live without on the road is my cell phone. It's basically my connection to everybody in the world, and I'll FaceTime or I'll be on Twitter or Instagram or just finding out about the news. But yeah, it's very important and you do not want to drop it in a bathtub. Three things that I can't live without on the road. One would be wet wipes. You can literally take a shower with wet wipes if you need to. The second would be my cell phone. The third thing would be just having us have instruments around because we're able to write, and that's kind of how we communicate with each other in the band. So lots of times after Fall Out Boy shows, I like to DJ. And what I do is I'll create a set in my room with this APC controller, and I've got it MIDI mapped to my laptop, and I'm able to directly change it. And it's awesome because lots of times I'll be like, oh, I just heard this song, and I'll add it to my set, you know, the night before in the hotel room, and this allows me to do that. The only way that I can like beat jet lag and like fight my way through it is to just get out and experience it. So I found myself, you know, we'd be in Tokyo and I'd be just like hanging in my hotel room, and it's like really about like going out and doing stuff and experiencing the culture, and the more I do that, the more in tune with it all I feel. Food and drink items I always need in my hotel room. Turkey jerky, basically never goes bad. You can eat it all the time, anywhere, which I'll do. And coffee, because I get up very early and do interviews on the radio, and I need this all the time. Something that I've had forever that I'm obsessed with and I always bring on the road with me is my Game Boy. It's an original Game Boy. It still works. It was customized by my little brother, I believe. But it's awesome. Like, I grew up in the 80s and I'm into all the nostalgia of all the stuff because the toys were crazy then. The thing that I found about balancing being a dad and being a guy in a band on tour is that the kids force the balance to happen. So it's like, when I come home, you just go in, you're in whatever situation it is. Before it'd be like, I have jet lag, I'll sleep for like 3 days and then like get up and eat Taco Bell or something. But it's like, I feel like the way our band has kind of like grown up a little bit, which is interesting as a band, we all have families and responsibilities now. So it's easier to do because we're all balancing it. So when I want to relax on the road, there's nothing like a good book. This one in particular is awesome because I'm obsessed with Star Wars, and this tells about the time between Return of the Jedi and the new film, which I'm geekily into. But reading's an awesome way to kind of like clear your head, and you can do it just about anywhere. Come read with me. I have a spoiler alert about my packing, and that is that I don't even pack my bag. I would lie, but my packer is here, so I can't. I think that I'm the kind of person who, I'm like a jump in the deep end of the pool kind of person, so if I don't have the stuff with me, I'll be fine anyway. The last thing I need my hotel room to have is the privacy sign, because sometimes I need to just hang out by myself. What a surreal life this is at this point.